fresh coffee and bagels too. A new day is waiting for us, we got lots of fun stuff to do. I take pride in ever working that day, can't see the use of it anyway. Who can think I'm such a load of crap? Growing up is just a trap.
IQ&A.
Welcome to IQ Not Applicable. I'm Big Mike.
Samuel Posnikov.
I'm Justin Bergy.
And we are minus said Alex. She is not feeling well as of late. So we're going to do this next couple episodes without her, but then she'll be back. So for now, I've been watching kind of two things lately.
Your penis?
And my penis, yeah.
And your hand.
And my hand. And how they interact. Yeah, it's like a study. I'm writing a paper on this. No, anyway, so, in all seriousness, not really. I've been watching two shows right now that I'm kind of, there's lots of shows I'm watching, but these are the two that I just decided to focus on today. So, one show I'm watching is called 112263. It is about a guy who basically tries to go, well, he does go back in time. He finds a way to go back in time. Not going to envelop on it too much. To try to stop JFK's assassination.
Oh.
So what we're doing and what we're going to discuss here, at least this first half of this episode, is...
The JFK conspiracy?
No, because goddamn, that would be a long time. But here's what we're going to discuss. Time travel. What would you do and why? Your preferred method of time travel.
Also, if we have a DeLorean or
a Tardis or whatever, yeah. Or something that you make up all on your own, whatever. And also, like I say, what you would do, your preferred method, and who would you go with?
Oh, who would I go with?
So I guess we'll start with, first of all, we have to get there. Before we continue, what's your preferred method of time travel? It could be from the movies, it could be made up.
The portals from Chrono Trigger.
Chrono Trigger? Okay, explain to
me. It's supposed to be a teleportation
portal. Explain, because I haven't seen Chrono Trigger.
Go ahead. It's not a TV show.
Whatever the hell.
Though the cutscenes are, they were originally drawn and written by, not originally, but in the PlayStation version, they were drawn and written by the same guys.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah.
It's kind of cool. But it's a video game, it's PlayStation. It was originally a Super Nintendo game that went to PlayStation. In PlayStation. PlayStation was the best version, I think. But what happens is, at this, not future, I guess, it's this fantasy world, they build these portals, and you can go from here to here instantaneously. So they do it, yep, the first person transferred perfectly. Awesome, works great. Let's try the next person. It's a girl who wears a pendant. The pendant, you find out, is linked to past, present, and future. It's like connected to everything. She goes in there with this pendant, it opens a fucking portal back in time.
Interesting.
Okay. You can't. She couldn't control it, though. But basically, Chrono.
You'd want to be able to control. Control.
Yeah, it. Of course. But it'd just be cool. Step on his pad. Woof, sucks you into a portal. It's like, holy shit.
Okay, so that's.
And then left the portal. And left the pendant behind. So Chrono grabs the pendant, jumps on there, like I'm going after. Goes back and finds out they go back to the 100 or 400 years before to the fucking Great War that almost destroyed the world. Mm. So that's where Chrono Trigger starts, and then from there, they go back to the dinosaur age and meet this like. Cave person, I can't remember if it's a boy. I think it's a woman. Yes, it is a woman. And then from there, they go into the future and meet this robot. It's pretty sweet.
So, okay, you, sir? I know you're a Doctor Who fan.
I would probably use a TARDIS. It's probably the best way.
Most comfortable way.
It's the most comfortable way. The most.
Don't need a road.
Don't need a road.
Yeah. Hey, sometimes where you're going, you don't need roads. You know?
And for some reason, it always drops you off somewhere in England.
Yeah, really? What's up with that? Like, come on.
All the matter of, like, the ability to travel through all of time and space and reality. This thing keeps dropping you off in England.
Yeah, that's strange.
Have you guys seen Miss Peregrine's School for...
No. Yes.
That movie's fucked up. There's time travel in it. Basically, they create these pockets of time. They can only record 24 hours in these pockets of time. And anyways, these people keep going around killing all these pockets and taking the what are they called?
They're like special, like there's people with special powers.
I can't remember what they're called. There's a name for them. But anyways, they go and they start killing him because it gives him power and whatnot. So they kill him and then he gets lost in time. He gets lost in the 40s and he goes back to his own time. He's like, well, how am I ever going to find these people again? Like, they're my friends. I miss them. And he fell in love with the one girl. He's like, I got to find her again. And he's like, you have a map of all these pockets of time and it's very updated up to 2015 and it's 2016. So these should still mostly exist.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you should go find her. So what he does is he goes from one pocket okay, this pocket is 1964. All right, from this pocket, there's another one over here. It's 1937. He goes over there, and then goes back, and he goes back in time.
Right.
And he eventually works his way through all these different time periods to 1940. But yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's a pretty sweet movie, actually. It's a lot better than I thought it would be. I thought it'd be another teen tween movie.
Yeah, no, I heard of it, but I never looked into it or anything. So, yeah.
Probably the TARDIS.
TARDIS. See, everybody's probably going to be like, oh, Mike, you like Back to the Future so much. You probably want to travel time travel with DeLorean. First of all, I'm big in many ways. To fit in a DeLorean would be very uncomfortable and very hard to drive.
I would even have trouble. I'd drive a Fiero, which is a small car.
So,
the other big problem with the DeLorean is that its fuel source is very unreliable.
Exactly.
Where are you going to get plutonium?
And another problem with that.
But see, they did.
Where are you going to have a road to drive?
Yeah.
You go back to dinosaur times. There's no roads. You crash into a fucking mountain.
Well, they just like in Back to the Future 2, they fix the plutonium problem by having Mr. Fusion, right?
Yeah. Throw anything in there, yeah.
But then in 3, as you all know, gas becomes a problem. So if you go, like, he's lucky he went to even with steam engines and whatever, like, there was a way to make the car sort of go fast. If you go back, like you say, to dinosaur times or whatever, what are you going to do? Are you going to tie that shit to the back of a
Tyrannosaurus?
or like 700 Raptors?
Hold on.
For the best?
I'm curious when the invention of gasoline was, because he went back to early 1900s, right?
But I can't remember. It's 1855.
Yeah, so there would be gasoline in the time, unless he's back in like the mid-1800s. Because in time he
1855.
Was... 1855. That's when it was? That's 18. When the movie was?
Yeah.
So no.
Weird.
Well, look up the invention of gasoline.
No, because the Wild West lasted all the way up to 1910.
Well, I know, but it doesn't matter how long it lasted. It's 1855.
Yeah.
But anyway, I think...
The invention of gas is like 20 years too late.
I would also think they should try to find a way to make that car more fuel efficient.
Yeah, really.
The one charge of plutonium, you get one trip on it.
And another thing, is, have you ever seen how good a DeLorean is on fuel? It's one of the worst vehicles to have on gas. That V6 is so horribly underpowered.
Yeah.
I'm surprised it even got to 88 mile per hour. I mean, what's the top speed?
And with all
speed?
The shit it's been through, like, I've been watching the Goldbergs, and one of his uncles pulls up in a DeLorean, and then it gets in an accident, and it totally bends the frame, so it's stuck with the doors open, so it's like it has wings. And he tried to call the DeLorean Motor Company, but they just went out of business, so they couldn't fix it, right? So anyway... There's no way that it would be a good preferment for the time travel.
Funniest thing.
What?
The DeLorean speedometer topped out at 85 miles per hour.
I know.
How would you know when you hit 88?
Steep hill, man. Steep
and
hill.
Its top speed was 100 mile per hour.
Yeah.
Now, what was its 0 to 100? That's my problem. Because if it's 0 to 100 is 25 seconds. Jesus Christ.
There's no way that Marty could have probably got from whatever to 85 in a parking lot.
Yeah. Those things aren't that fast.
And besides,
they were so horrible that when they rebuilt them in 2002,
the
new ones, the DeLorean V6 or whatever, they put a more powerful V6 in and they were still underpowered.
Yeah. See, and also, okay, I know we're getting on a tangent, but here's one thing I don't get. Okay.
Our guy, sorry.
No, it's not that. I'm not saying about that. I'm just saying we're talking about Back to the Future a lot. But anyway, Doc just told him, when this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're going to see some serious shit. And he witnesses this. So then later on, Marty's being chased by the fucking...
Libyans.
The Libyans, right, yeah.
Libyan terrorists.
I can remember it. So he's being chased by Libyan terrorists. And all of a sudden he goes, see if these bastards can do 90. Marty! Doc just fucking said...
88
is
the number.
That's what
might
it is.
Might want to remember that.
You might want to not... Fucking good
at
that. Exactly, like, but whatever. So anyway, and maybe he shouldn't have circled around the parking lot. Maybe he should have fucking left the parking lot. Maybe?
Yeah, he just circled around the parking lot. Well, these guys are going to find me over on the other side of the parking lot.
Maybe at JCPenney, it won't be a problem. But no, like, and then, and maybe he could have been driving and a cop would have saw this shit and then, you know, something would happen. They might have thought it's, why are there a bunch of wires on the back of the DeLorean? Instead of in 1955, there's a fucking spaceship on my fart. It's a little bit different in time gap.
And another thing, they'd be like,
why does this DeLorean suddenly have plutonium in it for some reason? And where did you get this weapon-grade plutonium?
Fair enough. So either
slap
way...
Slap the cups on this motherfucker.
Either way, it would have been screwed, yeah. So I guess you're right.
He'd be like, that old doc that's dead over there, riddled with bullets, he's the one that had the plutonium, not me. You're driving the car. Must be you. Fuck right there.
You're right. I guess basically... I guess it was justifiable for him to go circle around the parking lot.
No, it wasn't. He could have still outrun the cops by going back in time! Jesus, people!
Yeah, he literally goes back in time to, like, 10 minutes, but he's in a... No, because he'd have to go, like, back in time, like, say, a year, then go back... No, he couldn't go back again.
Go back in time for a year, then tell Doc, hey, I'm from the future, you fucking die! Problem solved. Yeah, instead, he just leaves it on 1956 or whatever it was. And goes back in time.
Marty's made some mistakes.
He's a teenage
Leave
kid.
Him alone. He's
he almost writes off a car in a race, in a street race. He ends up living upside down the rest of his life.
That's
after
George.
That.
That's George.
Was George, is it? Yeah. What the hell is George? Oh, he pulled out, didn't he? Marty.
No. Basically,
I can't remember.
He wasn't expecting to kind of do a sequel, and then they kind of needed him in there. But anyway, whatever. It's a stupid situation. We won't get on that. Okay, so I'm gonna pick my preferred method. Going back to that, I'm gonna pick my preferred method of time travel. Is probably gonna be the one in 11/22/63, where it's just in a closet. I literally just walk in the closet. Only problem is, I don't like the ramifications of the time travel.
Because you have to come out of the closet.
Exactly. There's that. Yeah, you go in there, you come out gay. That's the part problem time travel. No, the problem is you go into this closet or whatever, and you're always there on the same date. It doesn't change. You can't go forward, you can't go back, unless you stay there. So, for example, the time he goes to is like October something, 1960. As soon as he enters that time period, he can go back to his current time.
Oh,
but he can't go to the past. And the only way to go in the future is just to stay there and live there. Once you change something in the future or in the past or whatever, once you change something
back
in that reality, you can come back.
Oh.
But you can't go back. If once you go back into the closet after that, it totally just overwrites everything you did. So,
yeah,
for example,
you change the time again.
So, say for example, I've never finished the series yet, but say he goes and he stops JFK's assassination, right? Now he has to wait there 3 years, by the way, to do that. So he waits 3 years, he finds out or he stops it, whatever. He decides to go back to where he originally got in there, and he's fine. But if he wants to go back and change something, oh fuck, I guess I should have done this instead. If he goes back in there, he has to not only stay another 3 years, but he also overrode everything he just changed.
So it only goes to one date in the past.
Exactly.
Well, that sucks.
That's the thing. I prefer the method of time travel. I don't like the rules.
Because you get to come out of the closet a lot?
Exactly. But no, like I was telling Fergie, and I've said this a few times already, he has the most genuine reaction to time travel I've ever seen in any movie, okay?
Holy fuck.
Basically, he's like, he goes through, and he looks around, and he sees that he's in a different time, right? And he comes back, and he's like, what the fuck was that? It's literally like, yeah. Well,
normal.
That was October, whatever, 1960. Yeah, that's basically what would happen. Well, it's realistic. But yeah, like, that would be it's the easiest form of time travel. But you can't, the rules suck. I would probably rather, I'm leaning towards probably more of the TARDIS overall. Just because of the, first of all, it's comfortable a little bit.
It's kind of big and luxurious.
It's bigger than you think.
It can go anywhere you
yeah,
want.
Yeah, so like, okay, this is
for, but it has to be Britain.
For the nerds watching this show, forgive me, I haven't seen much of Doctor Who, so.
I haven't seen any.
You haven't seen any? So I know it's a giant room, but there is more to it than that.
There are endless, when you leave, like, there are doors. You
right.
can go out and walk around, and there are endless rooms.
Okay.
They're like a maze of corridors.
But it doesn't take long to time travel, though, does it?
No, it's literally like, you pump in, you go, you kind of shake around a little bit, and then goes thud, and then you're there.
Because, yeah, okay, let's...
And then prehistoric people are wondering why there's a fucking TARDIS sitting in the middle of
Do you remember
what is that?
Well, the funny thing is a police box.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right, I forgot it.
Okay,
yeah,
the
yeah,
actual
right.
police... Why it's a police box.
Yeah.
And technically, what a TARDIS is a big cylinder, is what it is. What it looks like.
What it
but it has a chameleon circuit, so it can
That's right.
camouflage into whatever it is.
But the one that Doctor stole when he left Gallifrey, the time lord, yeah, home planet,
right.
is broken. The
so it does random shit.
When he ran it, it's stuck as the phone booth. It can't be anything else. Yeah. It is locked.
So, like, for example, if you went back to prehistoric times, it could be a rock, but it's broken. So it's always a phone booth.
Like,
it's
the
a TARDIS-shaped rock.
Exactly. The Master, his big rival, also has a TARDIS. And,
oh, yeah, right, okay.
Okay. Well, she now.
Yeah, I'm not that far. But
okay,
anyway.
But she. But in the past, like, it turned into, like, a tree. It turned into, like... a wall. It's been all sorts of random things.
Mm-hmm. I would change my answer. The phone booth.
Are you going to talk from Bill and Ted?
Yeah.
Because I was just going to say how annoying that would be, but kind of fun. Because you're like, it's like a giant roller coaster. And you're literally just going like this, and it's so random, you don't know. And then you literally fly out of the sky and slam to the ground. That is terrifying to me. I wouldn't want to do that. Because first of all, you go on the ground, bro. And then... it's uncomfortable because only about two you could time travel. Because, okay, come on, let's get straight here. There's no way 11 people or whatever can fit in that phone booth. I know they're riding it sideways at one point, but it still lands.
Did they ride on top of it at one point?
No, see, what happened was it gets broken, so they fix it with gum and shit, which miraculously
somehow
works.
In this fucking scientific technology.
Bill and Ted are fucking just those geniuses for some
they're
reason.
They're those retards that act like, or those geniuses act like retards.
Yeah, exactly. So anyway, but no, at one point they're like, we don't got any more room left. And the booth is literally on its side, and they're all like standing in the booth, and it's like lying down. So imagine when it lands. First of all, you're going to come out of this thing flying, right? and if it turns sideways before it lands, 10 people fall out, instantly die. Change history forever.
Yeah.
Okay? Or it somehow does work with you and lands nicely. But when they land, they seem to all get out of the phone booth somehow, which is impossible. I don't know if it's TARDIS-like, where it's somehow they could fit all these people in there.
I just like the idea you pick up the receiver and dial them near you.
Yeah, that's why I like the 1122 thing. It's nice, it's quick, but at the same time, the rules suck, because it's just, the rules suck for that. And yeah, with Bill and Ted's phone booth, you just fall right the fuck out. That's why TARDIS is probably
next part, yeah, TARDIS is probably the best thing.
Yeah.
Next part.
What
no, Jules time machine is most preferable.
Oh yeah, like the
pictures of, what's his face?
He's sitting in...
big fucking dial behind her.
Yeah, but so what? Anyways. So what happens? Does that like go through a tunnel?
Yeah, it creates like a sort of a
space and time, and then they come through it,
and
okay.
Then you land wherever.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
What's his name again?
But that is an object you can't mistake for anything else, though, right?
Jules Verne.
Jules Verne.
Yeah, that was it.
Yeah.
Jules Verne.
Yeah. Anyways, okay, now let's get to the other question. Where?
Where would you go?
What time?
Oh. What would you change?
Would I change?
Would you change anything, first of all? Or would you just go to visit?
I would go back in time and stop the church from taking over everything.
The organized religion?
Because think of all the marvels we'd have if religion didn't stop it. Stem cell research is the new one. I watched a video the other day. They were repairing nerve cells with stem cells. They wrap it, and then they hit it with a laser, and it's like, healed. Nerve cells! You know how cool that is?
Hey, Christopher Reeve did it. He cracked open a cold cold baby and...
No.
Think about it. Like, oh, so far.
Have you heard about the guy that had a broken spine and couldn't walk, and now he's walking again because of this technology? Oh. And the religion is all over. No, it's living flesh from babies you're taking from fetuses. They can grow stem cells. They don't need babies.
Yeah.
Fuck babies.
Yeah, right. They can grow
they
stem cells.
They can farm
now.
It now. They
but
can grow it.
Technically, that would be considered an
act cloning.
Against God. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
If they think it's too close to cloning.
I'm just playing devil's advocate.
I know.
I know.
What happened? What happened?
We're at 20 minutes.
Okay,
I forgot to set the timer.
That's okay.
But anyways.
Oh,
yeah.
sort of keep it track. That's okay.
I would stop that. That was back in the beginning.
Okay, good. Actually, this will make our next episode. Okay. So. Anyway, yeah. Okay, so yeah, we'll try to wrap this up a little bit. We went over time talking about Back to the Future.
Anyways, go
anyway. Ahead. But no, like, hey, what would I do? Shit.
We have flying fucking cars by now. Anyways.
Yeah, really. honestly, I'm infatuated with mysteries a lot. Like,
you're
stuff
like
Jack the Ripper, JFK. I always lean towards Jack the Ripper right away. I just want to know who he is. I want to be, again, another role that would be nice for time travel is that if I'm just an observer. Like, I guess, like, Minority Report is not really
a time travel
movie,
it's
but it's
precognition.
Yeah, so
precog, yeah.
You can't that wouldn't work past wise.
No,
probably not.
Because that's memory.
That's right. Yeah, yeah.
Or as the doctor says, you know, premonition is just remembering things in reverse.
Fair enough.
I remember nothing.
So yeah, I guess I always lean towards that just because I'd like to know. But yeah, I guess that and just there would be so much little things that I'd like to find out about because I'm just always like that. I probably would want to, but I probably if I had to only pick one, it probably would be find out who Jack the Ripper is. But there's so many freaking things I could go back in time for just for finding out the mystery of you.
Ooh, for me, the same thing. You know, I'd like to just see events, like what the truth is. One I'd like to see is Roswell.
Yeah.
Yes.
Be like, they're sitting there eating popcorn be a good on the hill.
Who the hell's that guy over there?
I come in peace?
Why does he have a blue British box?
Yeah. He's like, what's that device in his hand? I'm sorry, what?
Alien!
Shit!
Yeah, there's not even a UFO crashing, that's just you.
Holy, like, mind blown. That's Roswell's all about you, and then they cover it up by pretending there's a fake green alien there, but it's really all about you. So,
have you ever seen Paul?
Yeah.
That's a good fucking movie. Anyways.
I just care about R.E.S. I like Paul. But yeah, okay, so I guess we could say who we'd go with, but... Like, I wouldn't say I'd bring my family with, per se.
No.
Because it depends on the status of the time travel, because if it's something in regards to... That could put them in danger, I would want that.
But you also look at, like, your TV show that you're watching. I can't remember.
11-22-63. The JFK Stephen King thing.
Yeah, that thing. If you get stuck there for 3 years, wouldn't you want your family?
That's another thing.
Yeah.
If it was the same, it depends on the reality, like I say. So if it was like 11-22-63, yes, I would. But I gotta say this too, again, getting into the plot of the show. They say if you fight with time, time fights back. Mm-hmm. So in this show, basically what happens is he's trying to mess with certain events in time, and he almost gets killed in certain instances. Things happen that... Kind of, it's like time fighting back. It's almost like a Final Destination type thing. Time's like, you can't do that. I'm fighting back, right? So, I mean, I could bring my family there, and they could, I could, if I'm messing with time, time could fucking with me and just totally murder my family. So that's another thing.
This is a thing that they talk a lot extensively in the Terminator series.
Mm-hmm.
Time's like a stream. It's going to go where it needs to go.
Yeah.
You can throw a fucking stone. You can throw anything. You can throw a fucking BMW.
This is basically what they say in 11-22-63.
Yeah, you can throw a fucking BMW in that street. You're going to change it for a second, but it's going to fight itself right back to its original path.
Yeah, exactly.
No matter what, you can only change it for a minute amount of time.
Are you sure you haven't seen the show or the book? Because that's almost verbatim what
that's
the movie
most,
says.
That is most time travel in general.
Yeah.
But then again, I believe in the branching effect. Mainly because of my little...
Well, in Star Trek, they really delve into the concept of the branching theory of time.
Okay, so which is...
It's,
our listeners...
I'll do it. Yeah. Most people think time is a straight line. You know, if you change something, the whole line gets wobbly. And With the branching theory is every decision that you can make, you do.
It already has a branch,
So you come to a decision... And, like, let's say you're driving down the street and you don't know which way you want to go. So, one, you have left or right. In one timeline, you take left. Another timeline, you take right.
Right.
And it
creates whole different timelines. So, let's say there was a timeline where you didn't marry Candace. There's a whole different group of timelines that branch off.
Yeah. I actually got into this conversation with my mom because I was watching it with her because she's a Stephen King fan. And I said that. Like, I said, this guy going back in time, he could literally turn left and... interrupt someone in the, like, because he bumps into this girl, right? And I said, what if that girl was about to meet someone or see something, mm-hmm. and it ends up
just completely it's
just like a domino effect, basically, like, oh, she doesn't meet this person, she doesn't bump into this person, that person's not late for a meeting, this meeting leads to this, and eventually it changes.
Apple's created in 1960 instead of 1970.
Exactly, that's what I mean, something like that. But yeah, I get it.
Basically,
that actually makes sense.
The only reason I believe in the branching effect kind of thing is because I have this weird little precog thing that I do, and I nobody believes me when I tell them. I'll have a dream about something, and I won't remember it. I'll wake up big. Oh, that was a fucking vivid dream. That seems like everyday kind of shit. Gone. Right after that. Then, about usually it's 10 to 8 seconds before it's about to happen, so I'll see something or hear something or smell something that kicks it off and I remember everything for the next 5 minutes. The problem is, if I don't do what I remember, it doesn't happen. And it's happened. tell someone, it doesn't happen because I didn't do that.
It's like
I saw a glimpse of that branch, and the instant I do anything other than what was in that branch,
Nicolas
diverts
Cage
it.
Movie. Yeah. Was that called Next or something?
Yeah, Next. Where he sees 5 minutes.
Or it's like that power in that Invisible Boy has in Mystery Men. It's like, I'm not invisible unless you're not looking at me.
I know, it's weird, and people don't believe me, but fuck is it ever.
I'm like Saran Wrap. I do have superpowers, can you see me? Yes, he's naked.
It's nobody ever believes me, but I can tell you right now, it's one of the most unnerving yet interesting things that ever happens to me. It happened to me the other day on a game.
Okay.
I was playing a game and something happened in the game. I was like, oh fuck, I know what's going to happen in this boss.
I'm gonna,
yeah, kind of. It's like that, but it's more vivid.
It's a glitch in the Matrix.
And things change. I didn't do it because I knew in the dream that this boss was going to kill me if I stayed in this position. I moved slightly to the left. Fucking his power or whatever hit and missed me. I was like, what the fuck? How the hell?
So I guess the answer to time travel is
it happens.
Slightly to the left.
Time travel doesn't exist so far because we haven't seen any time travelers.
I don't know. Have you seen some of the pictures of so-called celebrities?
I have a picture.
Yeah. Well,
I have a picture of a guy just standing in a group of people and everyone's dressed in fedoras and shit because it's 1930-something. And this guy's dressed in a t-shirt with a bunny hug and carrying a fucking camera like this. He's got sunglasses on. He's like, oh, this is pretty cool. Dude, you are not hiding if you're a time traveler.
What does that also show, that we just let idiotic people time travel? Because that's not good.
Yeah, that. Well, the one thing about the branching thing with Star Trek, they have, like, time police.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They have, like, because it's like, if you go fuck with the timeline, it's like, you could, think of it like this. If you go back to a set time, and you think of all the branches that come off of that.
Right. See them?
Oh yeah, I've seen this before.
Yeah. But say you go back and
we'll try to throw it up.
You fuck with that point. All of these subsequent timelines are going to be either erased or altered.
Right. Think of,
like, let's say you go back in time and you make a decision, and it results, you know, like the butterfly effect. You don't meet the person that you love.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right.
Think of how many times then that your child will not be born.
Yeah, right. And
there's only so many branches that your child was born. There's only so many branches that you married Canada. There's so many branches that this happened.
Yeah.
There's only so many branches where you're circumcised or not. There's just so
weird.
Many branches.
But no, like.
But that's what they believe time travel is you're just jumping branches.
The Flash kind of does that too. Like, what happens is the Flash goes back and he stops his mom from dying or whatever. And then he kind of fucks things up.
Yeah.
At some point, there's a guy in there named Diggle. He's on Arrow. He's on Arrow, and he has a daughter, or whatever. But Flash fucks up the timeline, and now for some reason, Diggle has a son.
Another branching point. And during Flashpoint Paradox, when he goes back into the future, Bruce Wayne was the one that was killed, and Thomas Wayne becomes Batman, and Martha Wayne becomes the Joker.
Watch the Flashpoint Paradox.
It's
on
amazing.
Netflix.
It's
actually
all
probably one of, it's probably one of the best DC movies I've ever seen.
Yeah.
So.
It's really good.
But
and Thomas Wayne's an asshole.
I love the guy who plays Thomas Wayne too.
Yeah, I know.
Kevin McKidd, the guy who plays him. He is, like, he's also on Grey's Anatomy. I love him on Grey's Anatomy too. He's such a good actor, he just has such a, like, when he emotes so well with his voice. He emotes so well with his voice. And I mean, he does a lot of different emoting. He's not as angry. Well, he does have angry moments, but he has this voice that he emotes so much through.
Yeah.
And it's probably a conscious thing he does, because when he talks normally, he's got a thick Irish accent.
It's a lot like Hugo Weaving.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's very much like that.
Yeah.
He did a whole fucking movie where he wore nothing but a mask, and he knew exactly what his emotion was.
Exactly.
Anyways.
Yeah, so that's time travel, folks. So until next time, I'm Big Mike.
I'm Justin Ferry First.
And I guess I'm Sam.
He guesses. So,
last time I checked.
Just don't go back in time and try to grope your mom.
Yeah, we didn't even touch the butterfly effect.
Oh, God, that's another fucking movie again. Fuck, I haven't seen that movie in a while.
Philip J.
Fry. Again. That, too. There's so much movies on time travel. Just literally, you need
see
a time machine to just watch all these movies.
I want to see Looper.
I've watched
Looper's
pretty good.
Anyways.
Later, guys. Anyway,
man, I wish we could go back and redo the whole episode.
Yeah.